here, and in the youth forum today. The European Youth Forum has been following very closely all these discussions on the future of Europe that were accelerated since the Brexit vote, when the leaders decided to have this self-reflection on what is Europe and how we do it, and then with all this Bratislava process that has been mentioned. And we have been really in touch with national governments via our members to make sure that the youth perspective is taken into account. What do young people think about the future of Europe? Because, like, the future of Europe, if not with us, like with them, like who do you do the future with? So we have been waiting for this white paper that President Juncker was doing in his high tower. And now I have to talk to you about scenario 4, which is named "Doing Less, More Efficiently." It sounds like the perfect solution, because everybody has something to say against Europe, like it's too much. Europe is taking care of too much things in your lives, and is not delivering proper policies. So with this title, you say, yes, less Europe, less burden, but better policies. But I'm not very convinced by this scenario. So let me first explain a bit. So this scenario is where member states decide on a series of priorities, and they do Europe, like they take European solutions only in a certain selected list of priorities. Here, for example, they propose that when it comes to external borders, only the EU would take care of external borders with the European border and Coast Guard. Terrorism, only at EU level with a specific agency on counter-terrorism. Then they discuss about innovation, defense. So they make a list of priorities. But then they say, on other issues, we don't do anymore. And this is a bit weird, because doing less, more efficiently only sounds like a political program for 1 year. Like this year we're going to work on defense and counter-terrorism. But at some point you're going to need to tackle other challenges. Like this is how European integration has been working since day one, is that it creates this kind of de facto solidarity. Like if you tackle one challenge at the European level, then you will need to organize yourself at another one. So it's difficult to see what it means with doing less and more efficiently here. Main question when it comes to civil society and young people is like, how do you decide on priorities? Is that only within the hands of the member states that can define that? Or will you allow space for the European Parliament to decide? Will you allow civil society to influence it, to force the member state to add a priority on this list of doing things more efficiently? So this is why I'm not very convinced with this scenario. Because in any way, if we are doing proper things like that are efficient, people will want more. That's proper sense. Who doesn't want policies that are not efficient? That's so weird. So if the doing less more efficiently works, then it's going to the next scenario for sure.